How's everyone doing? I'm all good, thank you. How's everyone doing? How are your celebrations? I'm all good, thank you. And my health is also good. So how are your celebrations? Celebrations kaise rahe? So enjoying birthday. Someone's enjoying their birthday. Okay, Paramjeet. Enjoying his birthday. Well, 15 August पर मैंने आपकी एक क्वेश्चनेयर प्रिपेयर किया. ओके, सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू रिज्यूम द रिवीजन सेशन जो हमने 33rd क्वेश्चन पे ड्रॉप ऑफ किया था. जून रिवीजन सेशन वो आज कंटिन्यू होगा. वी आर गोइंग टू होल्ड बैक टू इट. सो देयर स्टिल स्टूडेंट्स ज्वाइनिंग अप. सो Let's wait up for a few seconds more and then we'll begin with this. Mangalam Vision. क्या हो गया सर? So let's begin the session now, shall we? Let's begin with the 34th question. What is the name of the anti-money laundering platform which was developed by United Nations Office on Drugs and Crime? So UNODC developed a platform for anti-money laundering. What was the name of the platform? Us platform ka name kya hai? So, शौविक ऑप्शन बी देवाशीष गोएमएल, शौविक ऑप्शन बी हु गोएमएल, सुमित ऑप्शन बी सुनील ऑप्शन बी एंड द आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी गो एएमएल इज द प्लेटफॉर्म व्हिच इज एंटी मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग प्लेटफॉर्म. जो एंटी मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग प्लेटफॉर्म का मतलब जो पैसे घुमा देते हैं, जो ब्लैक मनी स्पेशली के साथ करते हैं, पैसे घुमाने का काम है, तो वो घुमाना रोकने के लिए दैट इज एंटी मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग प्लेटफॉर्म. गो एएमएल की फुल फॉर्म अगर देखी जाए तो गो एएमएल स्टैंड फॉर ग्लोबल ऑपरेशन एनी एंटी मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग. ग्लोबल ऑपरेशन एंटी मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, विच कंट्री हेल्ड इट्स इलेक्शन 60 ईयर्स आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस? गुड मॉर्निंग फरूक. गो एएमएल इज अ प्लेटफॉर्म जो मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग रोकने के लिए, एट इंटरनेशनल लेवल पे मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग रोकने के लिए ये प्लेटफॉर्म लाया लाया गया है बाय यूएनओडीसी. सो स्पेशली इससे क्या होगा, जो ऑर्गेनाइज्ड क्राइम्स हैं जैसे टेररिस्ट अटैक्स वगैरह होते हैं, उसके अंदर जो मनी ट्रांजैक्शन होता है उसको स्टॉप किया जा सकता है. 35th क्वेश्चन, विच कंट्री हेल्ड इट्स इलेक्शन 60 ईयर्स आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस? कौन सी कंट्री है जिसने अपने इंडिपेंडेंस के 60 ईयर्स बाद इलेक्शन ऑर्गेनाइज किया था? सो प्रहर्ष ऑप्शन सी, देवाशीष वेनेजुएला, फारूक मोरिटानिया. Naveen, option A, Venezuela. Amit, Venezuela. Shovik, option C. Well, the answer is option C, Mauritania. Mauritania is a country jisne 60 years of independence ke baad pehli baar elections kiye. It gained independence from France. So, a partly question which can be asked from static section. Now, static se isse kya question banega ki Mauritania ko kis country se independence mili thi ya kis year mein mili thi. So, it was from France in 1960. 1960 mein France se independence mili thi. Next, who is the new president of Mauritania? Now, we have discussed ki Mauritania mein 60 years baad election hue hai. So, who is the president of Mauritania now? Who has been elected as the president now? Devashish, option D. Shovik, option D. Venu, option D. Sumit, option D. Naveen Ghazani, sorry, Ghazauni. Jagtar, option D. Well, the answer is option D. Muhammad Uld Ghazauni has been elected as the new president of Mauritania. Next we have is who won the Innovative Research Excellence Award 2019. Innovative Research Excellence Award 2019. Kise mila tha? Who won the Innovative Research Excellence Award 2019? Vikram Seth, option A, Gaurav. Okay, so Naveen, option A. Well, the 37th question answer is option A, Dr. Gaurav Nigam. Dr. Gaurav Nigam won the Innovative Research Excellence Award. Ye award kab diya gaya tha? It was given in Asian Leadership Summit, jo ki Bhutan mein hui thi. It was in Thimphu, Bhutan. So, Thimphu, Bhutan ke andar this summit was organized. So, in case a secondary question is asked ki Asian Leadership Summit kahan pe hui thi? It was in Bhutan and the Innovative Research Excellence Award was given to Gaurav Nigam. Gaurav Nigam is the founder of iCare. iCare and Intelligentsia, dono ke founder hai Gaurav Nigam. 38th question, headquarters of Financial Action Task Force, FATF. Who is the, where are the headquarters of Financial Action Task Force? Venu says Paris, Shovik option C, Raj option D, Raharsh option C, Naveen Geneva. Well, the answer is Paris, option C. Paris mein headquarters hai FATF ke. It is an intergovernmental organization, 1989 mein founded, and it is an intergovernmental organization. Why it was in news, FATF news mein kyu thi? This answer is in the 39th question. First Arab country to get membership of FATF. First Arab country jise permanent membership mili hai FATF ki. This is the reason why FATF was in news and the answer for 39th question. अमित क्या इंडिया की है? इंटरनेशनल, इट इज एन इंटरनेशनल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, इंटर गवर्नमेंटल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। देवाशीष सऊदी, फारूक ऑप्शन बी, राज ऑप्शन बी, वेनु ऑप्शन बी, सुनील ऑप्शन बी। वेल एज आई सी ऑल आर गोइंग फॉर राइट, नवीन ऑप्शन बी, जगतार ऑप्शन बी, एंड द आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी। सऊदी अरेबिया इज द फर्स्ट अरब कंट्री टू गेट मेंबरशिप ऑफ FATF। ये पहले ऑब्जर्वर नेशन थी एंड उसके बाद नाउ इट हैज बिकम अ परमानेंट मेंबर ऑफ FATF। 40th question, which country became the first to ratify trade deal to replace NAFTA? NAFTA deal को replace करने के लिए जो नई ट्रेड डील बनी थी उसको ratify करने वाली पहली कंट्री कौन सी थी? धर्मपाल, we have continued the session. सो लास्ट सेशन में जून रिविजन चल रहा था जिसके अंदर अराउंड 33 क्वेश्चन वर डन, सो वी हैव बिगन फ्रॉम 34th क्वेश्चन नाउ, इसलिए इतनी जल्दी 39th क्वेश्चन एंड 40th क्वेश्चन। सो शोविक्स इज मेक्सिको, देवाशीष मेक्सिको, राज ऑप्शन बी, अमित ऑस्ट्रेलिया, फारूक ऑप्शन बी, मैक्सिको। वेल द आंसर दोज हु आर गोइंग विद मैक्सिको के रमन, शोविक, जगतार, आशीष, प्रहर्ष, करण, ऑल गोइंग विद ऑप्शन बी, मैक्सिको। यूर राइट, मैक्सिको इज द कंट्री विच बिकेम द फर्स्ट टू रेटिफाई द डील जो नाफ्टा रिप्लेस कर रही है। फर्स्ट वील सी नाफ्टा की फुल फॉर्म, इट इज नॉर्थ अमेरिकन फ्री ट्रेड अग्रीमेंट। और नाफ्टा को रिप्लेस करने के लिए UCMCA, दिस इज द न्यू डील जो अब यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स एंड कनाडा ने भी रेटिफाई कर दिए। सो UCMCA स्टैंड्स फॉर यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स मेक्सिको कनाडा अग्रीमेंट, इट्स USMCA, यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स मेक्सिको कनाडा अग्रीमेंट। इसको चेंज करा नाफ्टा को USMCA में। Who is appointed to the post of representative of India in the Council of ICAO? ICAO के काउंसिल में इंडिया को रिप्रेजेंट करने के लिए किसे चुना गया है? इफ यू वॉन्ट टू नो द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ ICAO, इट इज इंटरनेशनल सिविल एविएशन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। सो शौविक ऑप्शन डी, अमन ऑप्शन डी, फारूक ऑप्शन डी, राज ऑप्शन डी, जगतार ऑप्शन डी, प्रहर्ष ऑप्शन डी, शौविक ऑप्शन डी, एंड द आंसर इज ऑप्शन डी। शेफाली जुनेजा हैज बीन अपॉइंटेड एज अ रिप्रेजेंटेटिव ऑफ इंडियन ICAO। ICAO इज इंटरनेशनल सिविल एविएशन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड इसका हेडक्वार्टर कनाडा में है इन मॉन्ट्रियल। सो इट इज इन मॉन्ट्रियल कनाडा। हु लॉन्च्ड ऑपरेशन संकल्प? ऑपरेशन संकल्प किस फोर्स का ऑपरेशन है? All those who went with option D, Balmiki, Shubham, Prahash, you're all right. Let's get to 42nd question, Operation Sankalp. Naveen, Montreal, Canada. Yes, headquarters in Montreal, Canada. So, Shovik, option C. Amit says Army, option B. Karan, option B. Shubham Gaur, option B. Devashish, option B. Shovik, option C. So there's only one person saying option C, okay, two. Dharmpal and Shovik going for option C, everyone for Army and Coast Guard. Well, the answer for the 42nd question is Navy. So who has gone with option C here, right? Indian Navy launched Operation Sankalp. Yeh operation kahan launch kiya tha? It was in Gulf of Oman. जब ईरान एंड यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स के टाइज क्वेश्चन में आ रहे हैं, सो आफ्टर दैट इंडियन नेवी लॉन्च दिस गल्फ ऑफ ओमान में ऑपरेशन संकल्प. And it was basically to save the INS Indian naval ships जो deployed हैं Gulf of Oman में, उनको save करने के लिए this operation was launched. 43rd question. PM Modi attended G20 summit from June 27 to 29 in which place? So here we have one point of information, as G20 summit was organized from June 27 to 29. एंड ये कहां पे हुई थी? आई बिलीव मैक्सिमम ऑफ यू मस्ट हैव द आंसर्स. इट हैपेंस, आर्मी एंड नेवी में कंफ्यूजन हो जाता है. Gulf of Oman, yes, in Gulf of Oman. Okay, answers. Sunil, Japan. Aman, Japan. Shovik, Karan, Prahash, Dharmpal. Well, all going with Japan. Option C, you're right. It was in Osaka, Japan, where the G20 summit was organized. 44th question. India's first solar cruise vessel will debut in. India ka pehla solar cruise vessel debut karega kis state mein? It is soon to be announced. Shovik, it was in Osaka, Japan, not Fukuoka, Japan. 44th question. India's first solar cruise vessel. Where will it debut? Vasu, option C. Raj, Aman Raj, all with option C. Raj, Kerala. Devashish, Tamil Nadu. Shovik, Tamil. Well, the answer is Balmiki, option A. Shovik, Tamil. Well, the answer is Kerala. Isse pehle, India ka pehla solar ferry jo tha, wo bhi Kerala mein launch hua tha, and wahi company ab second project le rahi hai by the name of Solar Cruise Vessel. 45th question. Which two states jointly received GI tag for Namma Kolhapuri chappals? Kin do states ko jointly GI tag mila tha for Namma Kolhapuri chappals? So, Vasu says option A. Venu, option A. Raj, option A. Karan, option A. Vuk, option A. Tamil Nadu mein isse relevant kuch nahi hua hai abhi recently. Harsh, option A. Shubham, option A. Shovik, option B. Well, the answer is option A. Karnataka and Maharashtra dono ko GI tag mila tha, four districts of each state. Dono state se four districts the jinko ye GI tag mila tha. 46th question. RBI committee has increased the collateral free loans of MSMEs from 10 lakh to what amount? So, collateral free loans for MSMEs. Iska increment kiya hai. So 10 lakh से increase करके कितने amount पे collateral free loan for MSMEs है अब? Yes, Odisha was for Rasagola. Book right. So RBI committee has increased the collateral free loans. Collateral free loans की limit MSMEs के लिए increase कर दी है. कितने पे increase करी है? Vishal, 20 lakh. Vasu, option B. Shovik, 20 lakh. Well, ye question maine, I think, kai baar pucha hai. Raj, 20 lakh. Sunil, 20. Well, the answer is 20. 20 lakh collateral free loans ki limit increase kar di hai RBI ne. What is IMEI? 47th question. IMEI kya hai? Yes, all those who are going with option B, 20 lakhs, you're right. 20 lakh was the new limit for collateral free loans to MSMEs. Now we come to the 47th question. What is the full form of IMEI? So, ASU option A. Aman option A. Devashish option A. Aman option A. Sanjay Sudhir option C. Prahash option A. Shivam Gaur option A. Shavik option A. And the right answer is option A. International Mobile Equipment Identity. ये mobile number, mobile devices को दिया जाता है. It is a 15-digit नंबर, 15-digit नंबर है मोबाइल डिवाइसेस को दिया जाता है. एंड व्हाई इट इज इन द करंट अफेयर्स सेक्शन, इसको करंट अफेयर्स में क्यों पूछा है? बिकॉज द गवर्नमेंट इज ट्राइंग टू सेंट्रलाइज दीज डिजिट्स, इन डिजिट्स को सेंट्रल, IMEI डिजिट्स को सेंट्रलाइज करने के लिए CEIR. सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज लॉन्च इज ब्रिंगिंग ऑल दिस अंडर वन अम्ब्रेला वाय द नेम ऑफ CEIR और सेंट्रल इक्विपमेंट आइडेंटिटी रजिस्टर, इसलिए IMEI न्यूज में है. 48th क्वेश्चन. विच बैंक मर्ज्ड विद भारत फाइनेंशियल इंक्लूजन लिमिटेड ऑन 4th ऑफ जुलाई? कौन सी बैंक है जिसने 4th ऑफ जुलाई को BFIL के साथ मर्जर किया था? यस, इट इज 15-digit नंबर. ये मोबाइल डिवाइसेस के आइडेंटिटी के लिए होता है. सो व्हेन योर मोबाइल डिवाइसेस आर लॉस्ट, यू कैन रिपोर्ट योर IMEI नंबर एंड विद दैट योर मोबाइल कैन इधर बी रिकवर्ड और ब्लैकलिस्टेड बाय गवर्नमेंट. नो, इट सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट इज ट्राइंग टू ब्रिंग इट अंडर अ सेंट्रल अम्ब्रेला बिकॉज कई मोबाइल, काफी मोबाइल डिवाइसेज है जिनमें IMEI नंबर नहीं होता. मोस्ट ऑफ देम आर इलीगल डिवाइसेज, सो दैट्स वाई दे आर ब्रिंगिंग ऑन अ सेंट्रल लेवल नाउ. In the sense option B, okay. Prahash, Sanjay, Karan, all going with IndusInd Bank. You're right. Those who went with IndusInd Bank, this bank merged with BFIL. BFIL full form is here, Bharat Financial Inclusion Limited. Who is the Commander in Chief of Indian Navy? Commander in Chief of Indian Navy is. योगिता ऑप्शन बी. हु इज द कमांडर इन चीफ ऑफ इंडियन नेवी? शौविक योगिता ऑप्शन ए, राज ऑप्शन ए, ईशान ऑप्शन ए, सुनील ऑप्शन ए, करमबीर सिंह. वेल, दोज हु आर गोइंग विद ऑप्शन ए, करमबीर सिंह. एडमिरल करमबीर सिंह इज द कमांडर इन चीफ ऑफ इंडियन नेवी. ही हैज टेकन फ्रॉम ओवर फ्रॉम जून. मे, इन मे सुनील लांबा रिटायर्ड एंड हैंडेड ओवर टू करमबीर सिंह. 50th क्वेश्चन. नो, इट वॉज नॉट कोटक महिंद्रा अमित, इट वॉज इंडसइंड बैंक. 50th क्वेश्चन. विच कंट्री इमर्ज्ड एज द फास्टेस्ट इकोनॉमी इन एशिया पैसिफिक एज पर ADB, एशिया डेवलपमेंट बैंक के अकॉर्डिंग फास्टेस्ट इकोनॉमी कौन सी कंट्री है इन द एशिया पैसिफिक रीजन? योगिता, वी विल डिस्कस दिस इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. जो करंट अफेयर्स का सेशन होगा मंडे को, उस सेशन में वी विल डिस्कस दिस एंड वेरियस अदर थिंग्स गोइंग ऑन इन द रीसेंट डेज. सो वो हम अभी मंडे, आज फ्राइडे है, सो कल सेशन नहीं है, बट मंडे के सेशन में वी विल डिस्कस ऑल द करंट रिलेटेड अप टिल द संडे सेशन. ओके, सो डोंट वरी, दैट विल बी डिस्कस्ड. since it's a revision session, I believe disturbance in that would not help. So 50th question, fastest economy in Asia development as per Asian Development Bank. China maybe, Shovik option D, Guna India, Sanjay option B, Raj Roshan Bangladesh, Naveen option D, and those who have gone with Bangladesh, you are right. Bangladesh has emerged as the fastest economy as per Asian Development Bank, and iski growth rate kitni thi? It was 7.9% last year ki iski growth rate, financial year 18-19 ki growth rate 7.9% thi, and predicted growth rate is 8% for the new financial year. इसी के साथ इंडिया की ग्रोथ रेट वॉज ड्रॉप्ड टू 7.2%. कपिल, टॉपिक वाइज जो करंट अफेयर सेक्शन होता है वो होता है वीओडी में, जो अभी आएगा तो उस वीओडी में होता है टॉपिक वाइज, अदरवाइज दीज सेशंस आर नॉट टॉपिक वाइज बिकॉज दे आर कवरिंग अ डेली बेसिस डेटा. Yes, Karan, even I observed this and thank you. But yeah, they majorly come in banking and SSC, more of in banking. Banking ke andar zyada acha ratio hai comparatively. So 51st question, which two countries agreed to make DD India available for its citizens? 7.2%, Karan. So, किन दो कंट्रीज ने एग्रीमेंट करके डीडी इंडिया को सिटीजन्स तक ले जाने के लिए पार्टनरशिप करी है इंडिया के साथ? सो बांग्लादेश एंड साउथ कोरिया. बाय देवाशीष जैन सेज बांग्लादेश एंड साउथ कोरिया. शौविक ऑप्शन सी, सुनील ऑप्शन सी, संजय ऑप्शन सी, and the answer is option C, Bangladesh and South Korea, they have agreed. So in dono ke saath DD India ki partnership hui hai. So DD India will be telecast in Bangladesh and South Korea, or Bangladesh or South Korea ka ek ek channel, which is BTS World and KBS World, ye dono India ke DD free dish ke andar telecast honge in the English translation. Yes, South Korean TV, KBS World, and Bangladesh TV, BTS World, they both will be telecast in India on DD Free Dish. 52nd question, who is the president of Nigeria? Nigeria ke president kaun hai? Who has been elected as president of Nigeria? Vishal option A. Option A Praharsh, option A Abhilash, Rahul option A, Aman option A, Praharsh option A. All going with option A as I see. Aman, Shovik, Venu, Sanjay, Sunny, all with option A. Well, the answer is then option A. This great unity, Muhammadu Buhari, has been elected as the president of Nigeria. Why was this question asked? Ye question kyu tha? He was not elected recently. Election recently nahi hua tha. The reason is African Union Summit. Where was the African Union Summit 2019 held? African Union Summit 2019 कहां पे था? Vishal option A, Aman option A, Rahul thank you, Devashish Algiers, Sujay option C, Shovik. So if you had got the hint, Niamey is the capital of Nigeria. And the last question I told that Nigeria is linked to this question. So, Niamey, Nigeria was the place जहाँ पे African Union Summit 2019 organize हुई थी, एंड इंडिया ने 15 मिलियन यूएस डॉलर्स की फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड करी टू नाइजीरिया. इन दिस समिट वन इम्पॉर्टेंट डिसीजन विच वॉज टेकन वॉज FCFTA, विच इज African Continental Free Trade Agreement. This was pending from a lot of time. It has been approved by the African continent in the African Union Summit 2019. Next is, where are the headquarters of African Union? African Union ke headquarters kahan pe hai? Headquarters of African Union. Headquarters of African Union. Farooq, option C. Vishal, option A. Sunil, option B. Naveen, D. Sunny, option A. Indaljeet, option B. Well, those who are going with option A, Addis Ababa. That is the headquarters of African Union, and it is the capital of Ethiopia. So, capital of Ethiopia is Addis Ababa, and that is the headquarters of African Union. And this union has about 55 members approximately. Which country planned to ban sale of petrol and diesel cars from 2030? Kaun si country hai jo 2030 se petrol and diesel cars ban karne ke full plan mein hai? Which country planned to ban sale of petrol and diesel cars from 2030? Shovik, option A. Raj, option B. Sunny, Iceland. Naveen, option A. Option A. Shovik, option A. Aman, option B. So there's a confusion between A and B, Ireland and Iceland. Answer for those who are going with Ireland, you are right. Ireland is the country jo ban kar rahi hai petrol and diesel vehicle cars from 2030. Not Netherlands, not Iceland, it is Ireland. 56th question. Highest bridge in Asia at Kandrur is located on which river? Highest bridge in Asia at Kandrur is located on which river? It is in India, that's for sure. Shovik, Indus. Raj, option C. Shovik, Indus. Sujit, option Sanjay, option B. Venu, option A. Well, the answer is Naveen, option B. Okay, well, there's only one person, I guess I had seen one or two who went for Satluj. The answer is Satluj. The highest bridge in Asia at Kandrur is located in Satluj. Its height is approximately 80 meters and it is in Himachal Pradesh. Which state made GPS devices mandatory for trekking? कौन सी स्टेट है जिसने GPS devices trackers के लिए mandatory कर दिए हैं, seeing the weather there and the risk of life in that area? Farooq, no problem. Which device made GPS, which state made GPS devices mandatory for trackers? that is still to be built. Plus, it was the highest bridge we were asking, not the longest. Devashish, Himachal, okay. Himachal, Bhook, Jammu and Kashmir. Sujay, option C. Shovik, option D. Karan, option C. Aman, JNK. Well, the answer is Himachal Pradesh, option C. Himachal Pradesh, seeing the weather there, monsoon weather, and the due to weather, there are a lot of losses of life there. Therefore, GPS trackers have been made compulsory, GPS devices. 58th question. Who was sworn in as the pro-term speaker of 17th Lok Sabha? 17th Lok Sabha mein pro-term speaker kise banaya gaya tha? Okay, so who confused between A and B and finally comes to conclusion as Himachal? You're right. Shovik, option C, Virendra Kumar. Devashish, Virendra, Shovik, Virendra, Karan Singh, option C. Sunny, option C. Shovik, Virendra Kumar. Sujay, option D. Vishal, option C. Aman, option C. Well, you did not fall in the trap. Virendra Kumar is the right answer. Virendra Kumar was sworn in as pro-term speaker and the speaker is Om Birla. Yes, 17th speaker is Om Birla and the pro-term speaker was Virendra Kumar. 59th question. When will Facebook roll out its cryptocurrency Libra? So Facebook has its cryptocurrency by the name of Libra and when is it going to roll it out? Kis saal mein ye out hone wali hai? When will Facebook roll out its cryptocurrency Libra? Srinivas 2020, Prem 2019, Devashish 20, Shovik 20, Vuk 20, Praharsh option B, Kapil option B. Aman Raj 2020. Well, the answer, those who are going for 2020 and which is maximum of you are going, that is right. 2020 May, Libra is going to be launched. 60th question. Who is appointed as the new executive director of United Nations Environment Program? UNEP ke new executive director kise appoint kiya gaya hai? Who has become the new executive director of UNEP? Indrajit, option A. Sunny says Inger Anderson. Raj, option A. Farooq, option A. Shovik, option A. Srinivas, option A. Aman, option A. Meera, option A. Shovik, option A. And the answer is option A. Inger Anderson. UNEP ke headquarters are in Kenya. In Nairobi, Kenya mein headquarters hai UNEP ke and new executive director is Inger Anderson. Kargil War is also known as, kya name diya tha is operation ko, which is famously known as Kargil War. Option A. Okay, so Kenya, Nairobi. Yes, Kenya, Nairobi. Nairobi, Kenya is the place jahan pe headquarters hai. So Meera says Operation Sunrise. Shovik Vijay. Okay, Karan option C. Shovik Vijay. Indrajit option C. Devashish Vijay. Well, those who are going with Operation Vijay, you're right. Operation Vijay is the name of the operation jo diya gaya tha, and the Vijay Diwas is celebrated on 26th of June. Sorry, July. 26th of July is Vijay Diwas, which is basically celebration of the victory of Kargil war. 62nd question, who hosted the 14th session of Conference of Parties of United Nations Convention to Combat Desertification? Who will host the 14th session of COP of UNCCD? So, Srinivas, India, Devashish, India, Shovik, New Delhi, Raj, option C, Sunny, New Delhi, Vishal, option D, Shovik, option D, and the answer is option D. New Delhi, India will host UNCCD COP14, and ye kab hoga? 2 to 13th of September is this going to be held, and Ordos, China held the 13th session. 13th session Ordos, China mein hua tha. Next, Operation Sunrise 2 is a coordinated military operation between whom? Kin do countries ke beech mein hai Operation Sunrise? Akash, I can't until unless students are eager on increasing their levels. Otherwise, a question kafi form se ban sakta, and I can get you the most tough ones too. But the thing comes is that students feel they are being left out. So data I give in the form of easy questions. Myanmar, option C, Aman, option C, Praharsh, Srinivas, Naveen. You're right, option C, India and Myanmar is doing the coordinated military operation by the name of Sunrise 2. First edition February mein tha, second edition May mein tha, which was a 3-week long, jo June tak chala tha. 64th question, which bank has moved under the preview of RTI Act and CVC guidelines to ensure transparency and accountability? So, kaun si bank hai jo pehle RTI Act and CVC guidelines mein nahi aati thi, lekin ab aa gayi hai? CVC full form is provided here, Central Vigilance Commission. So, kaun si bank hai jo pehle RTI aur CVC ke andar nahi aati thi, but ab aa gayi hai? Srinivas, JNK Bank, Devashish, JNK Bank. Sujit, option B. Exactly, I can't give UPSC CA here. Either this platform is not for UPSC level right now. Serious UPSC level ka nahi hai. JNK, option C, okay. Miraj, Sujay, all going with JNK Bank, and you're right. We had discussed it quite a lot of times in middle also that JNK Bank ab RTI and CVC guidelines mein aa gaya hai after its chairman was removed. Chairman ko pehle remove kiya tha JNK Bank ne, uske baad hi aaya tha, because there were a lot of chances of corruption going on in there. JNK Bank mein kafi corruption charges chal rahe the. 65th question, who is conferred with Save Water Hero Award? Kapil, another lecture on Hindu editorial column related to Indian economics and foreign policies and rest to the parliamentary session. I'll try if that's possible. That lecture, if it's possible, I'll try for it. So, who has been conferred with Save Water Hero Award? Raj, option C, Souvik Tillu from Pune. Raharsh, option C. Aman, no idea. Karan, option D. Well, the answer is option C. Makarand Tillu has been given the Save Water Hero Award. And why has he given this award? In koi award kyun mila? He's a social activist and he started a campaign of replacing leaking taps. Leaking taps ko replace karne ka campaign unhone shuru kiya tha, and that's why he was given this award. 66th question. Who is the new president of Slovakia? Who has been elected as new president of Slovakia? New president of Slovakia. Chauvik, option D. Sunny says Zuzana. Meera says Zuzana. Indujit, option D. Mohit, option D. Sujit, option D. And the various other answers going with option D. Kash, Naveen, Kapil, all going with option D. Zuzana Kapitova, which is the right answer. The new president of Slovakia is Zuzana Kapitova, and the capital is Bratislava. And with this, we are ending our session for today. With this, we are ending our session for today. So, see you on Monday now. We'll see. Agar continue karenge ya new session banayenge current affairs ka. Until then, goodbye. Take care and see you on Monday.